Yeshua, Jesus, the Christ, bless each and every one of the lovers of His truth and those who follow after Christ. I pray that those of us who are celebrating the Lord's Sabbath are having a wonderful, blessed, peaceful, joy-filled, Holy Spirit-filled Sabbath in Him. All right? So you are welcome, and I thank y'all for your lives. Okay, guys, I have just a little under 15 minutes to record this because I am using a screencast. And so I'm going to share a lot of scripture reading with you, but I'm going to share some information and just a little background to this share. All right. So one thing you're going to learn about yourself from listening to this share, or clicking on the share, I should say, is if you are able to just listen. If you're a person who's able to just listen, take 15 minutes and listen. We spend so much time listening to other things, but can we listen to the Word of YAH being read? Can we listen to a discussion that is around the Word of the Most High YAH and fellowship around that truth for 15 minutes? The second thing you're going to learn about yourself is if you are a person who has an ear to hear, all right? You may not know it, but if I have the comments open and you make some crazy off-the-wall comments, then we're going to know if you had an ear to hear what the Holy Spirit is saying to the church. All right, so I pray that we will all have an ear to hear what the Holy Spirit is saying unto His church. All right, and third, we're going to learn if we are people who are able to endure sound doctrine. So enduring sound doctrine is more than listening, it's more than hearing and comprehending, but it's taking that word that we have heard, that we have comprehended, and applying it to our lives and bearing fruit of the Holy Spirit. All right, so you are all welcome, and I thank YAH for your lives. So by now you see the title. I'm not sure exactly what title I will give to this, but I know that this discussion will be on the topic of YAH's truth and YAH's wisdom, YAH being God, all right, and how none of us own a patent on YAH's truth. None of us own a patent on the truth of the Most High YAH, all right? And so this is a very, very important topic. It's a very important reminder to those of us who know this, all right? Because there is a temptation to try to take that glory to ourselves. Whenever we are people who share the Word of YAH, whenever we are people who the Most High gives wisdom, knowledge, and understanding to, there is a temptation, because Satan brings the temptation, all right? But yield not to temptation, all right? But he will bring the temptation for us to take that praise to ourselves. And then sometimes there are people, you may not be that type of person, but there are people who will try to give that kind of praise unto you and give the honor to you that belongs only to the Most High YAH. Now, I'm going to give you a little example that helped to encourage me to do this share. And I say encourage because it's already been on my mind to do a topic on this, but not just sure how, you know, it would come about. All right. And so I thank y'all that he uses even things that people intend for evil and wickedness, that God will even use that for good and most of all for his glory. So recently I received a comment, and I'm going to get into reading the Word of YAH to you, okay? But recently I received a comment from someone who basically, who just flat out told me that I did not have any light of my own, that the truth that I was sharing, okay, they identified themselves as a Hebrew Israelite, they said that the truth that I was sharing, that I had copied it from a particular Hebrew Israelite camp. All right. Now, I'm not going to allow Satan to use me, but I am going to speak the truth. All right. So it's up to you to perceive this in the right spirit, which is the spirit of truth. The camp that he named, all right, or they named, believe me, that would be the last, or next to the last, because it's two of them, that I would ever think about joining. All right. Ever. All right, or even trying to harvest anything from them. Now, I will say that I have seen, doing searches and such, you come across that, you know, different shares. I have seen their shares come up. I may have even listened to one of their shares in the past, okay? Actually, I think I've listened to at least two. One where I knew I did not want to listen to those people anymore, all right? I didn't even listen to the entire thing. And another where someone mentioned how they had attacked, how that particular, they said some things and it let me know that they were a part of some people who had attacked them, okay? All right. And so when they mentioned that the light that I was sharing, first of all, they recognized that it was the light of truth. They said that it was the truth that I was sharing, but they said that I copied it and didn't have any of my own, and that I should listen to this group and give credit to them. All right. And let people know that the information that I had came from that group. All of that was false. All right. First, I want to thank them for acknowledging that what I was sharing was the truth. Amen. And all praises to the Most High YAH. First and second, I want to thank them that what they acknowledged was light. All right. And it was the true light. All right. I thank and praise God for the Most High YAH who dwells in us, who is light. And I'll show you that in the word. All right. But I reject, all right, the lie that YAH's truth is limited to a group of people, any person, or any camp, association, denomination, or anyone, even those who name the name of Christ. All right, He gives His Spirit to those who will obey Him. All right, and so this is something that we have to remind ourselves, because as he continued to listen, because like I said, this was in a series of shares, and I'm not sure if I mentioned that this was the last share in that series, and it was rather lengthy, almost an hour long. I knew that he continued to listen because he mentioned some things that I noted in that share. But prior to mentioning the things that I said in that share, he said that I was a woman and I should not be teaching, but yet he continued to listen, and he continued to say that this truth that you just said, I know that you got that from this particular Hebrew Israelite group, and that I should give them credit. All right. And I should join them and listen to them. All right. So the purpose of this share is to remind us that all praises belong to the Most High YAH. All right. And that all wisdom, knowledge, and understanding comes from Him. All right. True wisdom. All right. That comes from above, not the earthly wisdom, which is devilish and sensual. All right. And comes from beneath. But the true wisdom that comes from above comes only from God. And to Him alone be all glory, honor, and praise. So the purpose of this share is to remind us that even if YAH gives us wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, or even if we listen to people who are sharing wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, we should never take it upon ourselves, and we should never point anyone to any man, because none of us have any wisdom, knowledge, or understanding of any truth that we possess on our own. 1 Corinthians chapter 2 says, "And I, brethren, when I came to you, came not with excellency of speech or of wisdom, declaring unto you the testimony of YAH. For I determined not to know anything among you except Jesus, Yeshua the Christ, and Him crucified. And I was with you in weakness and in fear and in much trembling. And my speech and my preaching was not with the enticing words of man's wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, and the power, that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men, but in the power of YAH. Howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of this world, nor of the princes of this world that come to naught, but we speak the wisdom of YAH in a mystery, even the hidden wisdom which YAH ordained before the world unto our glory, which none of the princes of this world knew, for had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, I have not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which YAH have prepared for them that love Him, but YAH have revealed it unto us, how? By His Spirit. So anything that those, even those things that have not entered into the hearts and the ears and of men, YAH has revealed it and prepared it for who? For them that love Him. And how has He revealed it to them? By His Spirit. Not by your favorite camp leader, not by your favorite pastor, not by your favorite elder, not by your favorite teacher, not by your favorite minister, not even by yourself, but by the Spirit of the Most High YAH. All right. And so he goes on to say, for the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of YAH. For what man knoweth the things of a man save the spirit of man which is in him? All right. So he's speaking about, we don't know any man after the flesh, basically, but the spirit of man, we don't even know ourselves after the spirit, after the flesh, but the Spirit searches all things, and he reveals us to us. He reveals truth. He reveals who is speaking truth to us by his Spirit. All right. Even so, the things of God knoweth no man but the Spirit of YAH. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of YAH, that we might know the things that are freely given to us by YAH. He says they're freely given to us, all right? We don't have to pay homage to any man. We don't have to give praises and thanksgiving to them. Of course, give honor to whom honor is due. But listen, my faith does not rest in the wisdom that God has imparted into anyone else. My faith is in the Most High YAH, who will pour out his spirit as he has done upon all flesh, and his sons and daughters shall prophesy. That's to proclaim his truth. So even among women who you say should be silent, but yet you continue to listen to me, and then you can continue to say that what I was speaking was true, but yet you wanted me to give that credit for the truth that the Holy Spirit has poured unto me, you want me to give it unto men. God forbid. All right. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of YAH, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God, which things also we speak, not in the words which man's wisdom teacheth, but which the Holy Ghost teacheth. Did he say your head elder? No, he said, not the wisdom which man's wisdom, let me read that again, which things also we speak, not in the words which man's wisdom teacheth, but which the Holy Ghost teacheth, comparing spiritual things with spiritual things. All right, so when you have the Spirit of God, you're able to compare spiritual things with spirit, with spiritual. All right, you're able to discern between carnal and what is spiritual, and then you're even able to compare the spiritual things with one another. All right, but it's not dependent upon the wisdom of men. It's not dependent upon the understanding of men. It's not even dependent upon the teachings of men or the insight of men or the knowledge of men. Thank YAH for good teachers who are filled with the Ruach of YAH, but I am not dependent upon them for truth, because this comes from the Holy Spirit, who teaches us all things. All right, but the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of YAH, for they are foolishness unto him. And see, he was a foolish person because he wanted to give praise for something that came from the Holy Spirit to a natural man. All right, he may have thought he was spiritual, right, saying that they have the true spirit and they have the light, and obviously I was copying from their spirit. But he lacked the Holy Spirit, because if he had the Holy Spirit, he knows that he will pour out his spirit upon all flesh, and his sons and his daughters will prophesy. Amen. There's no need to cipher or to draw or to tap into someone else's presence of the Holy Spirit in their lives, but God is going to pour out the Spirit upon all his children. He says, if you, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Father give the Holy Spirit to them that ask? All right, and not only that, he gives his Spirit to those who obey. So please do not allow these people to draw you away or to cause you to give praises and honor to men. Trust in the Most High YAH, who gives his spirit to us freely. All right, but the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him, neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. If he had the Holy Spirit, he could discern that I spoke by the Spirit of God that was given to me freely. All right, but he that is spiritual judgeth all things, yet he himself is judged of no man. For who hath known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. All right, when you have the mind of Christ, he will teach you all things. All right, so the light that you spoke about, that light did come from Christ, all right, not from men. John 1:4 says, in him was life, and the life was the light of men. All right, and as far as the truth goes, he is the truth. John 14:6 says unto us, Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. All right, Thomas was asking to know the way, and Christ wanted him to know that the way, he is the way. All right, he didn't tell him to look to Peter, he didn't tell him to look to any of the other disciples. He told him that he was the way, he is the truth, he is the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. All right, and so why do people do this? Why do people even allow people to do this? Why do people allow others to lift them up and to make them appear as if they are the totality of all wisdom, knowledge, and understanding? Why? Because they love the praises of men rather than the praises of God. All right, or giving praise to God. John 12:43 says unto us, for they love the praise of men more than the praise of God, meaning that they don't want God to praise them, all right, and to tell them that they've done a good job or well done, but they want men to praise them. And if this is your lifestyle, if this is what you have done, and this is what you are doing, and this is what you're encouraging others to do, cease, all right? God will not share his praises or his glory with anyone. All right. So y'all bless you. And I pray that this has turned your heart to the Most High.